The Intelligence Operations Center was created in response to the events that occurred back at James T. Vaughan in February 2017. There's a lot of reports that there was a lot of information that staff had, that other inmates had, that was being reported, but it might not have made it up to the highest levels of chain of command. The Information Operations Center is now able to be able to listen to those voices, bring it to one central location, and be able to disseminate all the different pieces and able to make a story that we can then send back to the facilities and say, we're listening to what they're saying. This is what we're seeing. This is what we agree, and make recommendations to the senior leadership of those facilities to say, you might want to think about moving some inmates. You might want to think about making some rotations within the COs. You might want to look at, you know, reducing some structure during hours or increasing programming, because, you know, we're hearing a lot of phone calls. We're seeing a lot of videos and those things that, you know, are causing some angst between the inmates community. This is also capabilities with our DTL tablet system, the DTL tablet system that the inmates have. They're able to do video visits, they're able to do message trafficking, they're able to do a lot to stay in contact with their loved ones and be able to have that hope. If those inmates didn't have those DTL tablet systems and they didn't have that hope, we would have so many more issues, but you just can't have that go unrestricted. And that's what we're doing. We're watching. We're making sure that people are following the rules, but we're making sure they're making those contacts in it. And that all overgoes to our safety and security. The Intel Operations Center has military analysts that were retired that we were lucky enough to be able to pick up from the Army. We have ones that are financial analysts that were able to do intelligence for large-scale corporations. So we're looking not only at information that we get from video visits, but also from the financials. We're looking at, you know, who's moving money, where's that going, why is that going to this area, and why is it that large? So we're being able to answer a lot more questions a lot quicker to be able to get answers to all of our staff members so we can stay as safe and secure as possible. So I'm excited about the IOC, what the capabilities it's going to be able to provide, because it's only going to increase the safety and security of our staff and our inmates that are in the DOC.